The following presentation of the Mass is made possible by your generous support of Catholic TV. Catholic TV, in cooperation with Channel 68, invites you to celebrate the sacred mysteries, listen to God's Word, and in the Holy Eucharist, proclaim Jesus' victory over death until He comes in glory.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Today we listen to the Word of God speak to us about the great miracle that takes place in the life of Moses, and also how that miracle expanded in the life of Christ is given to us as we are able to name God through the way in which Christ has revealed God as Trinity. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, you show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path. Give all who have for the faith they profess are accounted Christians the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and to strive after all that does it honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. Moses was tending the flock of his father-in-law Jethro, the priest of Midian. Leading the flock across the desert, he came to Horeb, the mountain of God. There, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in fire, flaming out of a bush. As he looked on, he was surprised to see that the bush, though on fire, was not consumed. So Moses decided, "I must go over to look at this remarkable sight and see why the bush is not burned." When the Lord saw him coming over to look at it more closely, God called out to him from the bush, "Moses, Moses." He answered, "Here I am." God said, "Come no nearer. Remove the sandals from your feet, for the place where you stand is holy ground." "I am the God of your father," he continued, "the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob. The cry of the children of Israel has reached me, and I have truly noted that the Egyptians are oppressing them. Come now, I will send you to Pharaoh to lead my people, the children of Israel, out of Egypt." But Moses said to God, "Who am I that I should go to Pharaoh and lead the children of Israel out of Egypt?" He answered, "I will be with you, and this shall be your proof that it is I who have sent you. When you bring my people out of Egypt, you will worship God on this very mountain." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is kind and merciful. The Lord is kind and merciful. Slow to anger, rich in kindness. kindness. God is good to all creation, full of compassion. The Lord is kind and merciful. The Lord is kind and merciful. Slow to
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. At that time, Jesus explained, I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We have been listening to the readings from the Gospel of Matthew and also from the book of Exodus these last several days. Today, chapter 3 of the book of Exodus presents us with one of the great manifestations of God's presence to the people of Israel. This is a very important matter for us because it reveals to us ways in which the action of God is going to continue to take place throughout history. And that is through his election, his choosing of those whom he calls to himself to be the ones to whom he reveals things, first of all, about what the mystery of God actually is. That is to say, reveals what is the mystery of his presence to those who come to meet Christ when he comes to the earth. But here in the Old Testament, Moses receives this call. And this is an important call because it begins the understanding of what God's action is in the world. It is an action of saving. It is an action of liberating people from those powers which can destroy them. It is an action which gives them life. And this is what Moses is called to do in the face of a mystery which he sees and is drawn to simply because of its naturalness on the one hand, namely a bush is on fire. But he notices that within that naturalness, something else is taking place, something which human intelligence doesn't anticipate, cannot expect, namely that the fire is not destroying the bush. The bush continues to remain as it is, even though it's aflame. This is very interesting for us because what it reveals to us is the importance of the way in which God uses the dimensions of our own intelligence to draw us toward him. And then within that brings us into an entirely new reality, the mystery of his existence. And that existence is shown to us as a way in which God has called us to be with him. This, you remember from the reading, is the sign that Moses is concerned about. How can I, he said, go to a Pharaoh? I who have no power, I who in fact stutter, how can I go and speak before the Pharaoh? And the sign is, because I will be with you. This is so important for us to realize, for Christ has told us this about himself, that he will be with us in all things. I think this is very important now for us to consider in terms of the tasks of new evangelization, which the Cardinal has so wonderfully undertaken within the Archdiocese. This importance of new evangelization, when sometimes we become afraid, we're uncertain, how will we know? What should we do? I will be with you. The Lord will be with us. And so it is that the mystery of God is always undertaken, not because we go off on our own alone, but rather because Christ is leading us and he is with us. We know about how Moses leads his people out of Israel because God is with him. We know, as the Matthew's Gospel teaches us, about the power of God in Christ Jesus, and that he reveals to all those whom he calls to himself. For he is God with us, and he is God with us now, as we continue to bring his word to others, as we continue to announce his salvation, as we continue to announce his hope, as we continue to celebrate the fact of his presence with us in the celebration of the Eucharist each day. Today, I especially also remember in this Mass Father Frank, Monsignor Frank McFarland, whose 12th anniversary of his death is celebrated today. I know many of you have known him so well, and he has been a source of such strength to many people over the years and has left this wonderful heritage that Father Reed has taken over and now continues. We pray for Monsignor McFarland and for all of those who continue to allow this word to be made manifest in God's world. Let us pray. O loving and gracious God, you are always with us, and so we turn to you, asking you to hear our prayers as we offer them today. We pray for Pope Francis and for Cardinal Sean, that in their lives and mission that they will bring the mystery of God's word and presence to all whom they see and touch, to all they to whom they speak. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all of the priests and deacons of the church, that they may be faithful, having been called by Christ, to continue his mission in the world. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all of the faithful, for they are called by Christ to be the ones who allow the world to know him through the way in which they live their lives, through their life of prayer and their life of work. Grant them your assistance and be with them. We pray to the Lord. We pray for Monsignor McFarland and also for all of those friends and family who are deceased, that the Lord, having promised to be with us, has also told us that he is with us in life and in death. We ask that these all now be drawn into the mystery of the kingdom. We pray to the Lord. And we'll offer now our own intention. Loving God, we thank you for having chosen us to be ones to carry your name to the world. Continue to assist us and be with us as we live our lives, hoping to do what you have called us to do and to live as you have called us to be. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands with praise and glory of his name, for our good and the whole gospel of the Church.
Look upon the offerings of the Church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you. Grant that when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty. Dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Cardinal Sean our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Go in peace. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
We have worshiped God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Lord has invited us to the altar, and this great prayer has brought benefit to ourselves, the church, and the whole world. Please help the television mass to continue by sending a donation to Father Reed, Catholic TV, Box 9196, Watertown, Massachusetts, 02471. Or watch and contribute online at catholictv.com.